Hey, did you give a damn about me when you aided and abetted the kidnapping of my wife? Held a prisoner on that island?
Yes, yes, yes. I have done terrible things, Chad. I'm the worst of the Damaris, and that is really saying something. But you're the best of us.
Well, that is a very low bar.
Yeah. Well, I think you came to this office to ask Marlena for some help. You see, I never asked for help. I was circling the drain and just doubling down on all things Damara. And now I have to ask permission to see my daughter, whom I love more than life itself. I can't even be in a room with her alone, Chad. I love her. I love her, but I wasn't strong enough or humble enough or good enough to put her first. But you are. You are. And you are going to get through this awful pain because not only do you love your children, but look at me. You are fundamentally a good man. You're going to put Charlotte and Thomas first. You're not going to fall apart like I did. Mm-mm. Because they need you. They need you, and you will be there for them. Because that is what good parents do. So I've been told. You know what? This may not mean anything to you. Chad, I am really, really sorry for what I did to you and Abigail.
The time that she was on that island was time that we should have been together. That is time that we will never get back.
You're right. I'm no use to you. I really wish I was.
I'll get back with you when hell freezes over. This is insane. It's not gonna work.
Wow, you're okay with Marlena dying?
If I reconcile with you, everybody's gonna know that you used the orchid to blackmail me into doing it.
No, they won't, because you're not gonna say anything about it. You see, no, because if you do say something, this whole deal is off.
You want me to go to Chloe and tell her, I don't know, I just can't live without Kristen. She's never gonna go for it. Nobody in this town is gonna go for it.
Yes, they will, because they know what a devoted father you are. And they'll see that your decision was because that you want what's best for Rachel. And they also know that Rachel hates Chloe.
Yeah, you made sure of that, didn't you?
God, come on, Brady. Rachel is miserable without me. She has been through so much already.
Yeah, because of you.
Just think about what you're giving her. Think about the opportunity to grow up in a home with a mother and father who love her dearly. Who would put her first, her happiness first, ahead of everything. And even Chloe will understand that.
You're a monster. You know that?
Yeah.
You're a monster.
No. I am a mother who loves her child. There is no hope for you and Chloe. So why don't you do a kind thing and end it with her now? Chloe's a big girl. She's used to rejection. She can handle it.
This is unbelievable.
I was so darn hard to believe. Susan Banks, moi, is one tough cookie. You didn't think you were going to get rid of me so easy, did you?
Does Marlena know?
Oh, well, you know, I haven't spoken to Dr. Marlena Evans, but...
Oh, I'll just call her.
I'm sure she is super busy, so there is no need to bother with that.
No, it's not going to be a bother. She's probably going to come right home as soon as she hears about this.
No, Brady, no. Brady!
Brady, it's me.
Krista, what the hell is wrong with you?
Mr. Cook, Mr. Clown Cook, Sandra, you don't have to do this. That heartless lady with the soul the size of a pea, she doesn't get to boss you around, right? And I promise you. You know what? If you just let me live, you know, live the long life that God intended me to, I promise you, I'm not going to tell a soul that you were involved in any of this. Not even my sweet, sweet, sweet Elvis. Nope, I won't tell anyone. Sandra, please.
I'm sorry, Susan. The stakes are just too high. I can't even trust Ava won't hate me now.
You're just going to murder me in cold blood.
You're not getting it. Sarah would never understand this, and things were just getting back on track. I have to do it for her.
No, you don't have
to. Please, just no more talking. It'll only make this harder for both of us.
Okay, it's fine. I'm going to listen. I want to listen to you.
I promised Sarah that I was a changed man. That her love changed me, but if she finds out what I did, she'll never forgive me. She'll see me for what I really am.
Okay, hold on. But you don't have to be. You don't have to be that. You don't have to do this. I'm not going to tell. I promise. I crossed my heart and hoped it. You know the rest of it.
Maybe you won't. But if I don't do this, Ava might just out of spite tell everyone. And I cannot lose Sarah against Susan. I can't. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh. Can I just say a prayer before you blow my brains out?
If you make it a quick one.
Oh, okay. I don't mean to be difficult, but I don't know any quick prayers. I'm a God-fearing Bible-thumping Christian, you see. And my sister Mary Moore around me, she's the one who's quick with the verse. Okay. I'll come up with something. Oh, please. God, just, so many prayers, so little time. Wait. I got one. Okay, and then I'm going to say this, and then I'll be ready. Oh, sweet Jesus, have mercy on this poor, poor man's soul. Now, Father, just forgive him. He knows not what he's done. Okay. I'm ready. You just... Shit away.
Damn it, I can't do this. I can't shoot you.
Oh, well, then, right? I guess my prayers for my life have been answered, even though I didn't have a chance to say it. Oh, okay, you know what? Let's, what do we do next? I mean, there is a supply room at the Brady Pub it's great for holding captives.
Just go.
What?
Just go before I change my mind.
Just go. Okay. You know, I'm gonna see you around.